This episode of Family Feud is brought to you in part by Coca-Cola Classic. Can't beat the real thing. And promos from Game Show Network. My Tiraculous, let's community.
Hot summer days, catching some rays. This is the life, these are the real things, and you're a part of it. Coca-Cola, every day and every way. Coca-Cola's a part of your life. Whoa, when Coca-Cola's a part of your life, you can't beat the feeling.
1 minute. Here's the first word. Go.
Me.
Ham.
Password, weeknights, 8:20-ish Eastern, only on Game Show Network.
Two beautiful girls. The top four answers are on the board. Mother Nature is, of course, not really anybody's mother. Name another such non-real relative. Melody.
Oh, dear, this is terrible. Uncle Tom.
She said, Uncle Tom. Lauren, Mother Nature is, of course, not a real anybody's mother. Name another such non-real relative.
Father Time.
Let me see. Father Time. It's there. 47 people said it. Ethan, another such non-real relative, my friend.
Yes. Baby nobody?
Baby nobody. You say baby nobody.
That's good. Thank you.
Thank you.
Baby nobody. Gotta get you one strike.
On,
we're okay because John is going to give us two of those answers.
Yeah. Not on your life.
How you doing? Good to see you.
All right, here's my answer. Uncle.
Oh.
No, I mean, because, you know, I don't want to give it away. No, I think it's Uncle Sam.
Yeah.
What?
Yeah.
What a good answer. Are you sure it's there?
Yeah. I'm positive it's there. It's the second.
Show me Uncle Sam.
Yeah.
There it is. 25 people said it. Carrie Ann, you look like you have no idea what you're going to say.
Deep breathing, right?
Deep breathing. Deep breathe.
I have no idea. Grandpa Joe.
Grandpa Joe?
Is there such a thing?
There's an Indian Joe.
Grandpa Joe. Indian Joe, then.
I can't help you. She says Grandpa Joe.
I don't know.
Carrie Ann? Well, that's two strikes.
Big buzz.
You're going to get a chance to steal. Now, Daniel is pensive and he's deep in thought. Mother Nature is, of course, not really anybody's mother. Name another such non-real relative. Keep it alive.
Well, this is for my mother, Mother Hubbard.
Yes!
Now, I'm pretty sure she was real, Dan.
Because I was raised in a shoe.
Show me. I could tell. Show me Mother Hubbard. Oh! It was a good try. You can steal it if you can tell me another non-real relative other than Mother Nature. What do you say, Jess?
How about Big Brother.
Big Brother, Doug?
Well, what's the New Year baby? What's that? What's his name?
I don't
Come
know.
On, help me on this, Ray.
This is not Jeopardy, Doug. I can't tell you. Laura Lee?
Mother Goose.
Mother Goose.
Goose. Yes.
Melody?
Aunt Jemima.
Aunt Jemima. Well, there's a lot of these. Stephen, what do you say it is?
I'm not, this is my own answer, but I'm going to say Mother Goose.
You're going to say Mother Goose?
Other people thought of this, but I thought of this too.
Okay, if it's there, you guys got that bank. Show me Mother Goose. Bingo! You got the bag. What is number four? Fairy Godmother. We're coming right back. Don't go away. We're going to try to give away $5,000.
The issue is clean water. We all have a stake in it. For wildlife. For recreation.
For clean ice cubes. Clean ice cubes to chill the light, refreshing taste of a new Coke. A chilling idea.
Elect the light, better taste for a brighter, better America.
The time is now.
The taste is light.
New possibilities.
New Coke.
Think about it.
I don't know why Wheel of Fortune is so successful, but I'm thankful that it is.
Here's the lady of the hour, or the half hour in this case.
I can't really tell you which one's my absolute favorite, but I like most of them.
Please welcome the very lovely and very red, Vanna White. Vanna.
I've worn over 5,000 outfits, but I like most of them. There are some that I don't like. I still wear them because there's so many, and there's so many people watching.
She wears a different outfit for every show.
He's been with us for a very long time. He is the voice of
Wheel of Fortune. $124,000 just waiting to be won on Wheel of Fortune. Now, here's your host, Pat Sajak.
I wish I could say something bad about him, but I can't. I can't. He's a great guy.
Nice of you to bring that up. Anyway.
He tells jokes all the time. He's a very funny person.
I like the way this audience oohed and aahed at the big prizes. Let's try it again. When I say a new van.
I will not turn a letter unless it's lit.
F3F.
Because it's hard to sometimes hear what the person's saying. My favorite letter is GSN. Game Show Network.
Catch Pat and Vanna weekdays on Game Show Network.
Please join us.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Buzzer. 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 Buzzer.
We are going to double the dollar value. We've got the top five answers on the board. We asked 100 people. Name something you have for breakfast when you're in a hurry. Laura Lee.
Orange juice.
Show me OJ. It's there. Four answers give you control, Ethan. Something you have for breakfast when you're in a hurry.
Cereal.
Let me see. Cereal. It is there. They take control. Yeah. We come over here to Mr. McCook.
Yes, to me.
You say?
I say toast.
Yes.
People toast. Do it all the time. Is number one toast? His. 35 people said it. That's Ariane.
Okay.
Don't blurt out an answer you don't mean. Say what's there. Something you have for breakfast when you're in a hurry.
A piece of fruit.
Okay. Show me a piece
that
of fruit.
Good.
That was
very
good. You took mine.
It was a good answer.
That was a really good answer.
It was a great answer, and I'll look into this.
Okay. Please do.
Daniel?
Yes.
There's only one strike. Something you eat for breakfast when you're in a hurry.
A sweet roll.
Two answers there. Is one of them a sweet roll?
Sweet roll?
No. Young and the Restless, a chance to take a really big lead.
No, it's not going to happen.
Coming up, if Lauren can't tell me, something you have for breakfast.
This has to be it.
What?
Instant breakfast.
An instant breakfast.
Good.
Sounds like a good answer. Did it make the survey? Instant breakfast. No, I'm sorry. Let us see. Young and the Restless. No, you don't have any more, Ethan.
Why need him?
Something you have. Well, because.
There's a pressure point here.
After what you go through on your show every day, you talk about this being pressure. Something you have for breakfast when you're in a hurry.
I just grab a glass of milk, I
guess. Glass of milk? Doug?
Donuts.
Well, you are aggressive, Doug. Donuts. Laura Lee?
Yogurt.
Yogurt?
English muffin?
English muffin. Melody, Steve?
Can I tell them what I think I should say, or do I just have to go out?
You can take one of their answers or go out on your own.
I have to go out on my own and say bagel.
Show me for that bank a bagel. Maintain the bank.
With it, kids.
Now let's see. You're only in trouble if they said one of the remaining answers. Number three. Yeah. Donut. Did you say that down there?
Yes, Ray, I might have mentioned it once or twice.
Okay, Doug said a donut. Number four. Coffee, which no one said. $215 for the bold and the beautiful, the young and the restless, 72. We go. Now you did not hesitate to jump on your teammate because
I didn't.
He made a bad choice.
Foolish move.
The dollar value is tripled. We've got the top four answers on the board. We asked 100 people. Name a day when you can bet there's a parade going on somewhere. John.
New Year's.
Did he make it, Judge?
Yes.
He did. He said New Year's. Two answers will give you control. Cool Doug, come here. A day when you can bet there's a parade going on somewhere.
How about the 4th of July?
Yeah. Well, you are very confident.
Parade.
Let me see the 4th of July. There it is. There you go, John. He did it to you. Was that your whole plan, to let him think he had a chance and then take his legs
yes,
out from under
no,
him?
No, actually not.
You were slow.
I don't know what happens to me.
Jess, what do you say? Number one is sitting there.
I think St. Patrick's Day.
It's a big, big, a lot of parades go that day. It's big, big, big. Show me St. Patrick's Day. Ooh, I don't know why it wasn't there. Steven, you guys want to settle down over there? We got a game going on.
All right. Yeah.
Well, again, this is a New York answer, so I don't know if I should. Doug, what should I do? I'm going to say Thanksgiving Day.
Thanksgiving. Bingo! Number one band. 42 people said it. Melody.
Oh, dear.
What is number four? You got that bank and possibly could win the game.
I know they probably only do it in Hollywood, but the Christmas parade?
Yeah. If it says Christmas parade, you got enough points, you're going to be playing for the 5,000. Let me see. Christmas parade. Oh. Laura Lee.
Well, I think this is a parade. The Easter parade?
Yes! Yes!
Is it there for that bank? The Easter parade. Not there, Bold and the Beautiful. One answer, and you're the champion. Today, when you can bet, there's a parade going on somewhere. Doesn't know. John.
Veterans Day.
Veterans Day.
Veterans Day.
Veterans Day. Veterans Day. Veterans Day. Laura.
Memorial Day.
Memorial Day. What are you going to say, Daniel, with them or out on your own?
Veterans Day.
If it's there, you're going to play for $5,000. Show me Veterans Day. No! The Young and the Restless take that back. Boy, this is a close one. What is number four? Memorial Day. Lauren, you said that, didn't you? Had you listened, you'd be playing for $5,000, $297 for the Young and the Restless, the Bold and the Beautiful, $215. We go with another face-off. Come on. Here we go. The final question. Jess, Carrie-Anne, I don't think I can breathe here. The dollar value is tripled. We have the top three answers on the board. Name something used as a table centerpiece. Jess.
Flowers.
Show me flowers. Number one, think of a steel. Steven, something used as a table centerpiece.
Candles.
Could it be candles? Number two. Yes. One answer, Melody. You're the champ.
That's what I was going to say. A holiday.
Okay, I don't think that was really an answer.
No.
She had a strike. Laura Lee, can you do it?
I'm going to say a piece of pottery.
A piece of pottery?
Yeah.
Okay.
Some sort of, like, vase type thing.
Show me a piece of pottery.
Oh, boy, Ray.
Doug,
oh,
a man, boy. If any man could do it, it's you.
How about one of those paper fold-out Hallmark kind of seasonal displays that have turkeys?
Show me the paper thing he described. Not there. We're going just for the steal and the game. Terry Ann, something used as a table centerpiece. Quickly.
I don't know.
Ice sculpture.
Ice sculpture. Oh.
A bowl of fruit.
A bowl of fruit, Daniel.
Candelabra.
There's a couple of things.
Bowl of fruit.
If it's bowl of fruit is there, you're the champion.
Only what you said.
The Young and the Restless.
I hope it's it.
For the game, show me fruit. Yes! What a comeback. I need two players for $5,000 right now. Who's playing first? Who's playing? Let's go. Off stage. Who's playing first? Bold and the Beautiful playing Fast Money for $5,000 for Age Project Los Angeles. Right after this.
This summer, Chicago, whatever you do and wherever you go, Coca-Cola Classic will be there. It's the one soft drink enjoyed across the nation 5 million more times every day than any other. Coca-Cola Classic, America's favorite under the sun. Ride Rolling Thunder and get $4 off gate admission to Great America with an empty can of any one of these Coca-Cola products. And ride the thunder.
He had it all. Jokers, money, and a brand new cedar love chest. But for contestant Bill Wantland, it was never enough.
I want that stereo!
With each victory, his obsession grew.
I can't believe how much I'm enjoying this game.
Until it was too late.
Oh, man, I can be addicted to this. Addicted to this.
He challenged the devil and lost. Bill Wantland, hear his story. Watch Game Show Network.
That's entertainment.
Are you ready?
Yes.
15 seconds on the clock, please. Good luck, Lauren. Name a piece of furniture that you would have to move when vacuuming the floor.
A sofa.
How many pictures on a roll of film?
36.
A place you'd see people eating peanuts.
A circus.
Any Walt Disney character?
A Goofy.
A good color for a purse?
Black.
Turn around, let us see how you did. Name a piece of furniture that you'd have to move when vacuuming the floor. You said? The sofa. Our survey said? 18. How many pictures on a roll of film? You said there were 36. Our survey said? 2.
Aye.
Surprisingly. A place you'd see people eating peanuts, you said? At the circus. Survey said? 25. Up to 45. Any Walt Disney character, there's a lot of great ones, but you said? Goofy. The Freudian slip? Our survey said? 5. A good color for a purse, you said, was? Black. What did our survey say? Over 100. Back with your teammates. Here comes your partner, Daniel. Mick Vicker, right here. You need 96 points. Look straight ahead. 20 seconds on the clock, please. You are tall. Good luck.
You are short.
Thank you. If we weren't in the middle of this, I'd say something, Daniel. Name a piece of... We already here? You shook me up, man. Name a piece of furniture that you have to move when vacuuming the floor.
The couch.
Try again.
Chair.
How many pictures on a roll of film?
36.
Try
24.
Again. A place you'd see people eating peanuts.
Ballpark.
Any Walt Disney character.
Mickey Mouse.
A good color for a purse.
Black.
Try again.
Blue.
All right, turn around here. I asked you.
Goofy!
That's what I was going to say you were, but I couldn't say it because she already gave the answer. And you called me short. Name a piece of furniture that you have to move when you're vacuuming the floor. You said? A chair. Our survey said 47, my friend. Excellent. Chair's the number one answer. How many pictures on a roll of film, you said? 24. Our survey said 43, number one answer. 6 points away. Good job. A place you'd see people eating peanuts, you said? At a ballpark. Did 6 people say it for $5,000 for the AIDS Project of Los Angeles? Our survey said you have it! Got $5,000, and we're going to come right back. Do not go up.
Then what'd she do?
She kissed me.
No.
Uh-huh.
2 cold ones. I knew a girl like that once.
You did?
We're playing this game called Spin the Bottle. And when it stopped, it was pointing right at me.
Then what?
She kissed me.
So what'd you do?
I married her.
Coca-Cola Classic.
Does Grandma know?
She's a little suspicious. How old was that girl?
Very old. 8.
Dollar values are double. Name something made of leather.
A purse.
You're going to be slightly embarrassed when I finish this question. Name something made of leather that a cowboy uses. So, Gene, didn't we see that cowboy roadside saddle?
Family Feud, weeknights, 7:40-ish Eastern on Game Show Network.
You're watching Game Show Network, where Now You See It is next with Jack Nard, followed by Child's Play and The Match Game.
If you can't get enough of Family Feud, get the Family Feud Ritual Edition board game from Imagination Gaming, free mental media. Get it today at your local Barnes & Noble stores.
Member of our studio audience will receive from the Lee Middleton Original Doll Collection the first moments christening awake doll, beautifully gowned and bonneted from Middleton Doll Company. Daisy Turbo Spa turns your bath into a luxurious stress-relieving retreat. Full power, full featured Daisy Turbo Spa. Introducing Pond's Water Rinsable Cleansers. Pond's cleans like no soap can. Ricola, all natural herb cough drop from Switzerland. Ricola soothes the throat and relieves coughs naturally for over 60 years. Veg All, mixed vegetables, great tasting meals in minutes. Look for our mushroom rice recipe in this month's issue of Woman's Day. Canfield's Diet Chocolate Fudge Soda is a chocolate lover's dream. No salt and only 2 calories a serving from Canfield's. From Television City in Hollywood, this is Gene Wood speaking for Family Feud, a Mark Goodson television production.
Well, well, well. Once again, we are going to the summer. Summer's coming up. So get ready for the summer of games. It's going to be dynamite this summer, baby. For the fourth year in a row. Get ready for the 2021 summer of games beginning Monday, May 31st. On both of my YouTube channels. Join us. Summer breeze makes me feel fine.